为什么你不可以有一个突破呢？
No， 为什么要讲这么长呢？ 我们是 co-host for a reason， 有没有？
No， I see myself as a special guest.
Why are you the special guest? What's so special about you that you have to be a special guest?
My mom told me
I cannot be special. Why I cannot be special? Why your camera don't come to me? Hello? Why is it called I'm not special enough?
Yeah, it's quite obvious who's more special already, right?
No! Okay, hi guys! Alright, we have... Let's see how many of you guys are watching, sorry. Okay, we have over 2,000 of you in Instagram. Hi guys! How's your week going? It's the second week of school, I would think so. So how many of you guys are actually back to school? Let us know in the comments, okay?
I bet a lot of you actually miss the holiday, right?
Hey, this is how Shipping is watching it!
Oh, is it?
Hello, Shipping! 你在吗?
Wait, are you looking at the Noontalk Media one?
Noontalk one. You're looking at yours.
为什么你不要看我的呢, Shipping? 为什么呢?
Sorry. Yeah, so Shipping is here. Hello, Shipping, 讲一讲电话. Okay, 刚才你讲什么? Sorry.
No, I bet a lot of them actually start to miss the holiday already.
Wow,
because that's how it was. But on the bright side, I mean, a lot of you actually still get to spend a lot of time at home, right? Like after school, you're supposed to go home anyway.
Yes, correct.
Yeah, if you don't have any activity to do at school, no extra CCA or anything, just head home.
Yeah, actually, anyway, I overheard this conversation with my mom and Zachary the other day, because I think Zachary is my nephew.
Oh, you're making use of your nephew again,
okay? I'm not making use of him, okay? But I'm just saying that day I overheard a conversation because my mom was probably a little bit worried about young kids going to school. And I'm sure a lot of parents out there are like that as well. Mm-hmm. Okay, but actually my nephew was very, very, very smart for a kid his age lah. You know, because I would assume primary school people will say that, but my nephew actually was like, oh, you know, actually it's very safe. The teacher teach us a lot of things, ask us to wear masks and all that, so very safe. He actually reassured my mom, and I actually had to recreate the conversation to show you guys what actually happened.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, come. I filmed a video. Hello.
A girl, second week of school, right? How is it?
I guess our boy.
School is very good. We have very strict safe management measures in school. We have safe distancing, everybody has to wear a mask, and we sanitize our hands very often.
That's very good.
But today Isabel didn't come to school. She told our teachers that she had flu-like symptoms, so they told her to stay at home.
Yes, that's the way. If you're feeling unwell, we must go and see the doctor immediately. Okay, if you don't have any after-school activities, come home straight away, okay? You can only gather with your friends when things get better. Understand?
Okay, understand!
Yeah, so technically, I mean, obviously, not so in-depth lah, the conversation, but my nephew actually really had to reassure my mom, and he actually had said that, oh, my friend didn't come to school because the teacher asked her to stay at home, that kind. So, very good.
Her, yeah. 哎呦, Zachary, 小小年纪, 为什么要这样呢?
不要问我, 从小就是, 很多魅力的, okay?
现在的小孩子很早说。<laughs> Yeah, but it's very right, you know, I mean, right now the situation, right, the time is very different from the past. Especially, I'll have to admit, I'm someone who very geikiang.
Why?
Yeah, and I very geikiang. I believe a lot of you are also like that. When you, last time, right, when you don't feel well, you're just like, ayah, no need see doctor one.
Yeah.
Pop some pills, drink more water, can really.
Yeah.
But now, that's not the way, okay? If you feel unwell, you have to straight away see a doctor.
Yeah,
that's what I'll do as well, because right now, it's not just about you not feeling well, but you are putting your family at risk as well. So, be responsible, go see the doctor if you're feeling unwell.
That's right, you really have to, so keep up your social responsibilities, okay? Everybody's lives is in your hands, okay? But you can be a part to make it safe for everyone.
Yeah, with everyone actually doing their job, right? We make the situation a lot better. That's why we have good news.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Yesterday was a very happy day, right?
Yes.
Yesterday, I'm sure most of you know that we have a few good measures
Yes, from 12 July onwards, right, you can dine out 5 pax.
Yes, from 2 increase to 5 now.
Yep.
So last time, maybe 5 of you guys, maybe you all will want to meet outside, but 5 of you cannot dine out lah. But
yeah.
Now, if you go out with your 4 other friends, then you guys can dine out together as well. And if you're with a family, 5 people in a family is fine too.
Yeah, like me like that, I'm always like, right now I'm the 3rd friend lah.
Oh no.
Yeah, who knows, maybe after 12 I'm like
the
6th friend. Yeah, but there are other things, like wedding now can have 250 pax.
Yes.
Pre-testing before the event have to be done.
Yeah, correct. Mm-hmm. And as well for gyms also, increase to instead of 2 per group, 5 per group now.
Yeah.
So actually indoor-outdoor classes can have like 50 people max,
mm-hmm.
right? But you will all be kept in groups of 5.
Yeah.
So still very safe.
And all the safety measures has to be done properly.
Yeah.
And of course, work from home is still the default, but workplace gathering also 5 pax.
Yeah, correct.
So you now can hang out with your friend a lot more easily lah, but still try to do it online lah.
Yeah, actually no need to gather lah.
Yeah.
Who will gather at work?
You can't Kimberly.
Why will gather at work ah?
Kimberly 从来都没有朋友的, 还不是活得好好的?
You are the 3rd and the 6th friend.
Don't expose me lah, I'm very sad.
It's okay, we'll be each other's friend. It's fine.
anyone want to be my friend, let me know.
Yeah. Everybody wants to be your friend lah, please. Okay, let's look at all the... Okay, Barbara says she's bored of work from home already. Oh no! Actually, I like work from home.
I love working from home.
Yeah, I would want to continue working from home.
They are so... Okay. You save the transport time.
Yeah.
You save the transport fee.
Yeah.
You save your, let's say, your makeup money.
Correct.
You save the hair wax money.
Yes.
And then you shower once you wake up, you shower once before you sleep. If you have to go to work, you shower once in the morning, then maybe sometime if in between, then you shower again before you go out.
Huh?
Yeah, that's what I do.
Okay, and this is new to me.
You come home, you shower again.
Okay,
then maybe after dinner, before you sleep, you sweat a bit, you shower again.
Yeah. Okay, true.
So, I love working from home.
Yeah,
and I can just noa in bed the whole day.
Yeah, especially it's so cozy at home, why you don't like? It's okay, you can always like meet up with your friends online and, you know, have fun. Then you can secretly do like other things when you are working that you cannot do at work. So why not?
Yeah, but because we spend a lot of time staying home, right? Which everyone with on our aircon.
Yeah.
Remember, please, to ventilate your house.
Yeah. Save your electricity bills also, okay? You don't need to 24 hours on the aircon. You must open and let the fresh air come in. Then you will feel, wow, it's a brand new day. Very nice. Yeah, okay. Let's see who else is watching us. Okay. Oh yeah. On Monday, we actually posted a picture, a very blurry picture of our special guest today. Do you guys know who he is? I think we've already let a few hints out on our social medias and everything. But do you guys know who he is? Tell us in the comments, okay? And don't worry, you'll be able to see HD later, not blur anymore.
HD life.
HD life.
But
caught in 4K.
Our viewers are all quite good at making their guesses,
yeah.
And their eyes are all pretty sharp, lah.
Yes,
so
yes.
A lot of them already knew. Yep.
Yeah.
So
like Evan Su says, who is coming today?
Oh, okay. Yeah. So, he's coming soon. And if you guys have any questions for him, you all can let us know in the comment section.
Yes.
We'll be watching your questions. And today, our first special guest will be Senior Parliament Secretary, Ministry of Transport, Mr. Bui Yam Keng.
Yay!
Yay!
Hello, sir. Welcome.
Hello, everyone.
How was your day? Has it been long?
Yeah.
I mean, it's close to 9 p.m.
It's past my bedtime.
Oh, no.
What's
your bedtime?
That's very early bedtime.
No, I'm just joking. But I woke up at 6 this morning.
Wow.
Oh,
okay.
You woke up at 6?
Yeah.
What for?
To drive my kids to school.
Oh.
Yeah, so that's what I do almost every day. It's also time to spend with my kids. Otherwise, I'm out the whole day, you may not have a lot of time to interact with them.
Okay, so usually, what time do you end your day?
So depends. Mm-hmm. So usually on Monday nights we have my meet people session, so that will end about maybe 11 plus or even midnight.
Wow.
So actually during COVID period now there are not many activities, so a bit better.
Ah, Yeah. I see, I see. So you have more time to spend with your family. Now.
Yeah, as well as work from home. Mm. So we do spend more time at home, yes.
I see.
Okay. Which I'm very curious because waking up at 6 a.m., right, is not something that most people do. Right?
I mean, we do lah like, when we have filming, then we also wake up at 6. So, but other than that, nothing.
Yeah, let's backtrack a bit because now it's close to 9 p.m.
Mm.
Yeah, so 6 p.m., send the kids to school. 6 a.m., send the kids to school, and then what's next?
Oh, then I went for a run this morning. Yeah, so I have a golden hour, a window after sending my kids to school and before I start work, about an hour plus, and that's where I do my running.
Wow, so active! Yeah, I mean, I see from your IG, you're really, really very active.
Okay,
so, was it during circuit breaker that you started picking up on exercising?
No, in fact, it's been more than 10 years.
Wow.
Yeah, when I realized there is this window in my daily routine that I can actually build in some exercise habits.
Nice.
And so far I've been able to maintain it. Yeah.
Mm, so you run only? What else do you do?
I do a bit of weights at the gym. Yeah. So,
yeah.
I think it's important. I mean, each of us should find something we like. That we can do it as part of routine because I think it's difficult if you have to make a great effort, you know, to do it. So if it's something that you can, it's this particular window that since I've got nothing to do, let's do this and do that, then become a habit and then you just get used to it.
Picking up good habits actually—that's very, very important.
Yeah. So I know a lot of people out there, right? They like to say that, I would love to exercise, but I have got no time. You make time, okay?
That's an excuse, okay? Yeah. We have a very, very busy man here today, and then, sir, you're very good at keeping up with all your good habits.
Yeah, I mean, as a senior parliamentary secretary, Ministry of Transport, right? I believe if you can do it, so can you.
Mm.
Yeah, and then, so after the run, what's next?
So I start working, clearing emails, and then I have a couple of a Zoom meeting, then after that another meeting. Then I went out for dinner with my wife.
Wow.
Before coming over, yeah.
Oh, okay, okay.
That's
very fruitful day. Yeah. What do you do today?
What time did you wake up?
I woke up at maybe like 10 a.m.
It's okay. Old man needs less sleep, yeah. So.
No, that's not true.
Okay. I'm even like paisy to tell you about my day already.
Me too, okay, don't ask me.
It's okay.
Yeah, but we also know that you recent that you started like a Telegram account?
I had a Telegram account for a while, but a Telegram channel.
Recently,
yes.
Yes, okay, so why would you set up a Telegram channel? Because from what I know, my social circle of friends, only the younger ones, I would say, would actually have Telegram.
Really?
Not the older ones would probably still stick to like the
I learned
WhatsApp
from PM. PM has sponsored, but must copy him.
I see.
Yeah. Okay. It came by because I was talking to someone, a young man, and then asking him what the social media, things that people are doing active on. He suggested Telegram channel. So, okay. So I just started. So still building. Very few, only 175 subscribers. So please subscribe to my channel.
Okay, how do we do that? Okay, I'm going to do it now.
I must send the link, right?
A link, yeah, right?
You
have invitation link. I don't have one, but Noontalk has one.
Okay.
Noontalk has one as well.
Okay, our viewers who are watching this,
yes.
Whoever have the link, send it in the live, okay? Live comments and then everyone please go and
Okay,
follow, right?
Yes.
Join the link. Join the
link. Join my Instagram, my TikTok also.
Oh yeah, we have your Instagram also actually.
Yeah.
We have actually your Instagram.
But to me, it's all these different platforms are channels for us to reach people. So to me is I must be where people are.
So
I do know that different like Facebook to Instagram, there's a generation gap, right? so I try to cross different generations. Just trying lah. Some might work, some won't work, so it's okay.
I think we really must keep up to date lah.
Yeah, right. I mean there are constantly updates of different social media platforms, and technology is just advancing at a very fast pace. So how do you ensure that you keep yourself tech savvy and be updated of all these things to interact with everyone?
Learn from you. No, really, I observe what people do. I have to, whether personalities, celebrities, people in entertainment, in sports, people who want to connect with the public.
Yes.
Yeah, and learn. Sometimes you just learn from mistakes. experiment. And I think I quite enjoy it. Yeah, because then there's always fresh things to do, new things to learn, and try out. Sometimes we exchange notes with friends, and you know, check out what are the latest trends, and just try lah.
I see that you're also on TikTok, right? We're also live on TikTok, so do you want to say hi to all your TikTok fans?
Hello. I've been TikTok for actually more than. A year? Is it more than a year? Yeah.
A year?
Yeah. Is it? Yeah.
Wow. A
so
year is about.
Is it more than a year?
It's quite long, actually.
Yeah. Or is it this year? No, last year. Yeah. No, last year. Before circuit breaker. Yes.
Wow.
So more than a year. Yes, correct. I started around February last year.
Wow.
Yeah. So, but I think TikTok is you need a certain talent, and age is not on my side.
Nice.
very young people. I mean, but try law is okay. I think it is actually very creative, and TikTok has a lot of interesting features.
Yes.
That
all the filters and all
help
that.
Us to create content quite easily.
Mm,
so I find it quite refreshing. Then you just dabble with it and try and see what's suitable for someone, you know, like me.
Okay.
Yeah. I know Kimberly got a lot of followers on, yeah, TikTok.
No lah, yeah, I actually went to comment on first TikTok yesterday. Yeah.
What's the biggest challenge that you faced doing this? Like all this digital stuff, online stuff, what's the biggest challenge?
I think the biggest challenge is myself.
Mm-hmm.
Overcome my own, perhaps, inhibitions want to do something that may not be something I'm familiar with. So for example, TikTok, I see people doing challenges, the dance steps, I can't. So I won't dare to try that. So, but how do I still create something that can connect with people?
Mm.
Yeah, and so I'll say try, and then sometimes just learn from mistakes. Yeah, of course, when there's encouragement that you comment, I think it's very encouraging to me.
Okay,
someone noticed it and drop a note.
Mm.
So all these would be good. But of course, there are also some people who don't think that we should be doing such things. So I get some not very positive comments that, you're so free, why you do this? You know, why are you trying to act cute? You know, you know, this already, you're doing this. But I try to take it in my stride, that probably they don't mean it, maybe they don't really understand it,
maybe
they're trolls. So actually every kind of encouragement is very, very important for us to encourage us to carry on with it. But I think that it is really a channel for engagement. And I think on TikTok, I've done a few live chats on TikTok. I do get very, very, very good questions. And I was quite surprised. Pleasantly surprised that supposedly the younger group may not be so interested in what we do in our policies or whatever, but they do, they're quite curious and they have been quite engaging on TikTok Live.
That's great. I think while the world is really, really changing, it's like now the technology world, it really helps us in our day-to-day lives. Right?
Yep.
Okay, so we have a game challenge for you today.
Oh, really?
Yes,
okay.
And we have a pop quiz, so we have a list of transport questions to see whether you know the transport well or not.
Okay.
I'm sure you will pass your flying colours.
Before I join Ministry of Transport, I must pass a test, you know.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so that's been about, 4 or 5 years, so I hope I remember my 10-year series.
Right, actually, that was one of the questions that we wanted to ask you, whether or not you had to learn about the whole history of,
transport. Of course. That's why Minister Iswaran just joined Ministry of Transport. He has to pass a test also.
Oh, really?
So he's the best person for you to quiz him next time.
Okay, next time.
So if anyone of you are actually interested in joining Ministry of Transport, right, you have to do a lot of homework.
Yeah.
I can pass you the 10-year series.
Nice.
Because to be honest, right, I've read through some of the questions. I had no idea what's... Okay, maybe one or two I do know the answer, but majority
Hopefully,
of them... Yeah, it's not that
easy. It's a bit hard.
Yes, a lot of memory work involved, definitely.
Yes. Okay, so shall we start? Okay, we have the first question.
For our viewers, if you know the answer, let us know in the comment section below as well.
Yes, okay? See if you can answer faster, okay? Okay, so first question is, which year did the double-decker buses start operations? Let's see what the double-decker bus looked like first. Ooh.
Oh, but this...
谁啊? Zong很帅哦.
Do you know him? Can you recognize?
I've seen this before. Yeah.
You've seen him?
Yeah.
Guys, if you spot my pearly white double decker bus advertisement,
so this is this year.
Take a photo with it.
This year, yes.
So answer is this year, 2021.
No, not this one.
You asked me this bus, right?
No, not exactly this one. The actual, when did the first double-decker bus in Singapore?
In Singapore?
Mm.
Long time ago. I remember as a young kid in primary school, I've seen it already.
In primary school?
Yeah. What? So must be in the 1970s.
Wow.
I was born in 70, so family one in 77.
Oh.
So I remember in the early years, because as a young child, it's very exciting to go on the top deck.
Yes.
Then we try to find a seat at the front. Then you can be the driver, right?
Correct.
So must be in the 70s. Probably late 70s, around then.
I see. Okay.
Yeah, I remember when I was a kid, I loved the decker, double decker as well. You know, last time, the bus, right, when I was young, so when the driver have to look up, they have this hole there.
You remember?
You have to see the mirror which shows behind.
It's like a periscope, right?
Yeah, you have to see, right? Oh, can I? I suddenly remembered this double decker joke that I heard in primary school. Do you want to listen? It's a bit lame.
Okay. Sir, let me get you a jacket. It's a bit low.
Okay, so there's this ama on the double decker bus, but she's on the first floor. Mm. So then a small little girl came up the bus. And then the ama asked the small little girl, "阿哥，不要上去，很可怕." Then the girl's like, "为什么？为什么?" Then the ama just, "不要上去，真的不可以上去，很可怕的." Then the 阿哥，为什么？ And the ama 讲, 你不要上去，上面哦，没有司机在驾那个车。
好像。
哎，你戳一下啦。Oh my god，好笑吗？OK
啊，OK啊，好笑啊。Not bad啦，OK啊，OK啊，OK啊。
I mean, okay.
You just felt like you put me.
Okay, right.
You put me in the bottom compartment of the fridge instead of the freezer. So not that bad.
Not that cold. Okay. Yeah. But yeah, okay. Double decker bus. Fun.
Yeah, I remember we were doing physics in school. Also, we learned about what CG, right? Center gravity double decker bus. It's designed such a way it won't topple.
I didn't know that.
So it's very safe.
It's very safe.
I think when we first started, will it be so high, will it just topple?
Mm.
Yeah, then remember, in school we learned that, okay, there's no way that you will ever topple.
I see. Mm. Yeah, I didn't know they started so early though, because my impression of older buses is the buses with the without the air cons. I remember, I think very young. But I didn't know the double-decker buses were already there during that period.
Yeah, so I think it's that time, I don't think they're all aircon also. As in 70s, most buses not air-conditioned. In fact, you have to pay 10 cents more to take an aircon bus. And a lot of passengers, commuters, will rather wait for the non-aircon bus because they want to save money. Because you're used to natural ventilation. So you think, why should I spend money for aircon? Then sometimes maybe only about a 10-minute ride. They don't think it's worth the money. And so it was, a lot has changed. Right? Today, all vehicles are air-conditioned.
Right.
Van or, the lorry cabin or whatever. It's amazing.
That's how much our bus changes throughout the past few years, right? There's like a lot of improvement. What else had a lot of progress and improved a lot is MRT.
Mm.
Yes, and the next question will be MRT related.
Okay.
So, sir?
This is a very simple one. I think everybody knows.
送分题.
Okay.
Okay, right?
Please name a color of the... what's the color of the downtown line?
I don't know. Blue.
Yeah.
Because it passes by my constituency in Tampines.
Mm.
So there's a Tampines East, Tampines West and Tampines Station.
Three
stations in Tampines on the downtown line. Mm. So I know, yes.
Okay. Actually, we like the downtown line.
And look at our map. MRT map. As you remember, when I was young, there was only like...
Only
green and red, right?
Yes, correct. Only green and red. Then yellow.
No, the first time it started was...
Green only?
No, it's actually double color for each line.
Wow, I didn't know. I didn't know about this.
Because it started in 1987 when I was in JC1.
Okay.
And only like 5-6 stations.
Okay.
I think Bishan to Braddell or whatever. I was living at Topayo.
Okay.
So it's one of the stations. So one of the first stations, only like 5-6 stations.
Wow.
Okay, so I remember it's going south is red line. Going up north is yellow line.
Mm.
So the north-south line has two colors. Huh. Then east-west line, I think going east is green. Going west is blue.
What?
Yeah, then later on, because of too many lines, there's not enough colors to go around. So they decided to have only one single color for each line, both directions.
Wow. I love it. I love this.
So now
history
we have
class.
A lot of like purple, orange and all this like brown.
Right now it's just so convenient. It's like everywhere we want to go, right? There's a MRT station nearby.
Yes.
Yes, and I can't believe I was not a pioneer. I didn't see on the pioneer line.
Why do you want to see on the line?
I mean,
too long
then I can
already
tell my I can tell my kids lah. So,
but there'll be a lot more stations and lines being built under construction now. In fact, we just announced that some of the TL, the Thompson East Coast Line.
I'm very excited for that
open,
one.
Yeah, later, very soon.
Very soon?
Yes.
Okay. Wow, it's amazing. So how different are the older MRT, the trains itself, compared to now?
The train, I think it looks about the same, as in the same type of seats. But I think we have more railings now. Right, I think we introduced some railings throughout the cabin so that people can hold on to it.
Right.
Yeah, I think in the past, when the door opens, the space is all empty. Then now there are railings that you can hold on to.
Understand. Okay.
The seats are the same. It's all those plastic kind of seats, easy to maintain and quite comfortable. Now there are more panels. Advertisement, but also for information of the lines, the station. Now you know which station is approaching, right? By the colours in the past it's just
it's a plain board. Picture.
Yeah,
right?
And it doesn't it's not dynamic. Last time no LED screen and all these things.
And then you have to constantly keep a lookout whether it's
where now or you hear the announcement.
And last time no interchanges. Now we have different lines when they cross, we have interchange. In the past, it's just simple platform, two different directions, that's all. So a lot simpler. And I think today, we also make our stations very beautiful. A lot of artworks, sculptures, installations.
Nice. Yeah.
Yeah. So I think it adds character and identity to the station and to the location.
Actually, a lot of the stations are very, photo-worthy,
Instagram-worthy, right? Yes, exactly.
Okay, so the third question is, you have to name a station in the Circle Line. This is easy also.
Any station. Labrador Park. Because it's near my office, the Ministry of Transport. Yeah.
Okay.
Our viewers.
Okay, very easy.
Which station are you? If you stay on a station in the Circle Line, let us know.
Yes.
And the circle is not a circle yet, no?
You still have, is it?
Yeah, there's a gap, but we will be completing it soon.
Where?
See the southern part.
What's the other?
I don't know, I think it's Marina Bay. So we are building, and then there's this, the last gap. Yeah, will be closed.
You see that? A few more stops,
yes.
Is it?
Just one or two stops.
Nice.
So it'll be a real circle.
Okay. Wow, real Circle Line. It's so cool. Singapore's so small, but we can have so many. It's really accessible.
Yes.
You don't have to worry anymore about transport.
Yeah, right? And it's like, just nearby my house, right? I think there are like 3 or 4 MRT stations.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, it's so convenient. So last time I would usually be worry maybe my mom is coming back from work, does she have to walk very far or certain stuff? No, now she just I know the MRT station is so nearby.
Yeah.
So she can just get home very easily.
Very good.
And our plan is to make 80 or 90% of our population to be within a 10-minute walk.
Nice.
To a station.
Okay.
Yeah. So it will be very convenient.
Right. Even for the end, because I stay at Pasir Ris at the end, right? So I'm all the way at the end. So will I still be near MRT station?
Aren't you already near some stations?
Okay. 10-minute walk. Maybe 12-minute walk.
Okay. Walk faster lah.
I mean Kimberly.
Okay. I'll walk faster.
Kimberly have quite short legs, so it takes longer for her to walk.
Okay, I'll walk faster, but no, it's very convenient. It's now still very convenient. Okay, next one. We have total 7,000 viewers now.
Is that good?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Very good.
Yes.
Yes.
A lot more than my live chat. Yeah.
Now because we have two platforms now. Okay, we'll show you a picture now.
Okay.
On the screen. And can you identify what is this card for?
Yeah, of course. It's a single trip card. It's a card. It's an MRT card.
Is it like a first generation kind?
Yes, one of the earlier ones. Yeah. So basically, it's called single trip card. So you use it once and then the machine will eat your card. Right? We still have it now. But actually, these cards are actually a lot more expensive than buying EasyLink, where you deduct from the store value, right?
So
usually these are for tourists, who will not stay long. So and very very few people are using it now. So in fact, we are looking at actually how to encourage more people to go on EasyLink. And but also more important is the Simply Go.
Yes.
Have you heard of that Simply
Go? I have. So yeah. Last time, I think maybe 5 years ago, I would actually buy the single-use transport ticket because I will always forget my EZ-Link card. Mm. But now, as long as I have my credit card or phone or anything,
correct.
I can just use it.
Correct. You don't need a separate card. So your credit card, as long as you register with Simply Go, or your, even a phone,
yeah,
you can just tap.
Yeah.
So convenient.
Very easy. Yeah. I don't have to worry. Don't have to bring so many things out now, actually.
Yeah.
So actually, right now, everyone's life is really very convenient. Mm. And I bet, right, a lot of our viewers haven't even seen the card before.
Yeah, I think it's a very long time ago, probably.
So let us know if you've seen this card before. And your answer, yes or no, we'll know whether you are uncle or titi.
Okay. Okay, a lot of people are saying they use their phone, they have signed up for Simply Go and all that.
Oh, good.
Very good. Go digital now. Okay. Are you ready for the next question?
Yeah, Goli 90 said MRT card. So I know
MRT
he
card.
Or she is uncle or
she. It's called EZ-Link card now, okay?
Yes.
Okay. What is the iconic colour for taxi in Singapore?
Iconic.
One of the iconic colours.
I would say one of the...
If you go back last time, is black with yellow top.
Oh.
That is, I think, the first generation of taxis.
Ooh.
And they are owned by the taxi drivers themselves.
Ah,
so they own the vehicle.
So it's not like a company.
Like now they rent, right? From you know, Comfort or SMRT.
Yes.
So I think as a young child, that was the first taxi I remember.
Ah.
Then later on, we have Comfort Taxi, which is blue.
Mm.
Then we have City Cab, which is yellow.
Yeah,
then now
there
are so many companies, red, grey, and silver.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so
I got give you a lot of colours already.
Mm, yeah, actually it's all already. But yeah, one of it, yeah, is yellow. We were looking at yellow, blue, and all that. Okay. Okay, very easy lah, our question.
Yeah, I mean, come on, don't we have like more challenging questions?
I think don't have We prepare one. Okay, the next one, for buses.
Okay.
What is the iconic colour? Now.
Now it's green. Now.
And
that was chosen by public.
It was chosen?
Yeah.
I didn't know about that.
Because
Okay.
Actually, last time it's red.
Yeah, I know. I remember,
not too long. Few years ago.
Yeah.
Then there were some changes and LTA bought over all the buses.
Mm-hmm.
And to give it a uniform identity, we want one colour. So I think there was two choices, I think. Red or green.
Mm.
And public voted.
I see.
And green was the favourite. The more popular one.
I think it makes sense because it's much more striking on the road. So you can always see the buses everywhere you go.
Yes.
Yeah, right? I think it's much more striking.
And then and also it's part of our green plan also, right?
Yeah.
Because
electric
vehicles,
buses,
I think we also watch our carbon footprint.
Mm.
So there are also hybrid buses, electric buses.
Yes.
In fact, we're going to change all to be a cleaner bus fleet very soon. Even some of the buses now, they are trying with solar panels on top of the bus so that they can generate electricity for the bus use, unit operation. Yeah.
So
actually a lot of new technologies being used in our public transport.
Wow.
Yeah, for example, you know, our MRT track, the tunnels, we need to do maintenance and checks, right? We use drones. So that it's easier, instead of a person walking the kilometers of tracks, right, use drones to inspect, you know, look at the cables, the railings, to make sure that everything is in order.
Wow, very
That's
cool!
Amazing.
I didn't know about all this, I'm so glad I learned all this today.
Yeah, and so far it's 100% hit rate for all the questions.
Yeah.
And before we proceed to the next question, BB_20 asks user, what is your pastime?
What do you do?
I don't have a lot of free time. So I listen to music. Mm-hmm. I have a Spotify list. So usually when I'm driving, I'll listen to that.
Okay.
I watch Netflix and recently Disney Plus. I just watch Loki.
Oh, Loki! Me too! Me too! I'm also watching. Very nice.
We are all Loki.
Yes.
Really? Why?
In Loki, everyone's called Loki.
Okay, fine. Okay, next question. We're gonna show you another picture. Okay, wow, I like this.
I remember this.
I know. Bus ticket.
I think it's like, I have to answer this, I already know lah.
You know?
I actually know.
But this is already, the second generation of bus ticket. Have you seen the first generation?
No.
The one with a lot of numbers.
Is it must punch?
Yeah, then a bus conductor will have to punch the number that indicate either your the stop that you bought or you went to, the last stop that you have to alight.
Oh, yeah. So a bus conductor will always be on board?
Yeah, so a bus, your driver and a conductor. Mm. So the conductor will collect your money, fare, your money, then they even give you change. I want to buy 50 cents ticket or two or whatever. Then you collect money, give you change, and then pull out two tickets, punch a hole, and hand it to you. And you're supposed to hold on to the ticket in case the inspector comes to check whether you have underpaid for your journey. Yeah, but those are very iconic. I think there are collectors out there who collect those tickets because you can't find it anymore. And it's interesting. And the bus conductor will have a slab with all the different ticket prices in different colors.
Wow, how do they remember? They just
you buy based what 20 cents, 30 cents, $1 whatever. They just
how many stops?
Based on your they'll know where you're going to stop and how much it is. You can even check. I want to go to Chinatown, how much the ticket, then you pull out the relevant ticket, punch a hole and give it to you.
Wow. Yeah. Very old school, but very
so this song we see is already like electronic, you have the machine.
Yes.
Yeah, so you just tong the coin. You just, last time you need to press which ticket you want.
And you'll come out ticket.
Yes.
Yeah, so actually our last question was actually the thing that you just mentioned, which is the tong tong thing.
Tong tong tong.
What is it called? A ticketing machine?
Yes, it's called, I think last time the total of us called OMO. One man operation. Improvement from last time conductor plus driver, two men.
This, right?
So now it's one man, so the driver drives, then you basically automated. Yeah. But I think at one stage the bus driver can even give you change.
Yes.
I remember change, that. Right?
Yeah.
After
I remember.
They stopped it and now it's all to the card.
So interesting. That one was from primary school days, because I remember my mom would give me like the exact coins, then I will be able to take the bus.
Looking at all this actually bring back a lot of memories.
Yeah.
Yes, kids, those of you watching this, let Uncle Zijie tell you. Last time when Uncle Zijie after school take the bus go home, I tong the coin inside the machine, duck one ticket come out.
Yeah.
I think the ticket I see on the double decker bus all the go up to the back, see there four paper aeroplane with that one. Then no, 不见了.
Oh, hey, there's an inspector.
If you call yourself uncle, then why? Who am I?
I don't know, this one I cannot answer.
I mean, in a lot of very youngsters out there, above 18 is uncle to them.
Really? Oh no, that must be dinosaur then.
No.
So we are actually in the same category, really.
So, right now, students are going back to school, right? Mm. So, how have you guys kept like the public transportation safe for the students going back to school?
Well, I think even at the beginning of COVID, when we were all very worried about the virus, public transport has always been a very safe place for people to come together. Because it needs to transport many, many people,
whether
in the bus or MRT train, right? No clusters have happened ever before in public transport. Although our buses and MRT are all air-conditioned, you think that it's enclosed space, but actually, at every station or bus stop, the doors will open.
Yeah, correct.
Right, so there is a in and outflow of air.
Oh, so it ventilates.
It ventilates.
Okay.
But the ventilation system within the train already changes over the whole air, all the air, within every 6 minutes.
Oh,
so you get a fresh breath of air every few minutes. So it is very safe.
Something like in airplanes where the air kind of is like
airplane, really. I think because you don't take air from outside,
right?
I think
so,
but the filters and things, it's also very safe. Of course, aircraft is a lot more sophisticated than a train and a bus, but it is very safe.
Kind of,
we did some studies with research institute, so they did all these tests and they certified that the air within our public transport modes are very safe. But of course, we also need all commuters to play a part, always wear a mask and actually try not to talk. Not on the phone or whatever. Just enjoy the ride. And of course, watch out for your own personal hygiene. So if you touch the railings or whatever, just don't touch your face, wash your hands. Because the operators are already cleaning the bus and trains more often.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they also
sanitize.
Yes, that's right. Yeah. So no worries. It's very safe and continue to take our public transport.
Yeah, but do you think because of COVID-19, has the ridership actually lowered?
Yes, compared to pre-COVID, definitely, because a lot more people work from home. And we're also encouraging staggered hours. So companies to allow the staff to have flexi hours.
Right.
Don't all come in as in the morning.
So not at like peak hours.
Yeah. So in fact, work from home is still by default.
Yeah.
So even at initial transport, we take a lead. We only go into office when there are meetings. And so a lot of meetings can also happen via Zoom or Skype. Yeah. So actually, a lot of things we learn through this pandemic that can be done digitally.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why? Are you like mesmerized?
But of course, most important is to vaccinate.
Yes.
Yeah, that's why students above 12 are already able to be vaccinated. Right? I think the latest figure shows us, is it 90%? 80% of the kids in the age group have gone for vaccination. I think it's very encouraging because that is the best protection against the virus.
Yeah. How was your own vaccination experience?
Oh, like? I joined the bus captains when they went for the vaccination.
All
then.
Together? Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Yeah.
So interesting. Okay.
Quite okay. I was sort of assured by the nurse that it's actually a very small, very painless, right?
Yeah,
have
you
gone for vaccine?
Yes, I have.
Yeah,
have
I'm you getting gone? Mine to, my first dose tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh.
Yes.
It's not uneventful. I mean, nothing you can't even feel, right?
I didn't feel anything,
Then, so my arm felt a bit sore after the first jab. Then the second jab, I had a bit more, I feel a bit more tired. For about a day or two, I didn't have any fever. So for different people, some have milder, some say nothing. Then they were asking, "I got no reaction. Is it good or bad?"
I think everybody's body reacts.
Yeah, reacts differently. But nothing serious, and you know, take a Panadol or rest a couple of days. You know, all will recover very well.
Okay, so you don't have to worry tomorrow,
Yeah, I'm
not scared, right?
I'm not worried at all because most people around me has already got their vaccination done, and everyone's been telling me their experience and nothing to worry about.
Yeah, really nothing.
But do encourage the elders at home,
your
parents or grandparents, because what is concerning is that those above 70 has the lowest rate of vaccination. So maybe some are a bit apprehensive about it, or some may be not very mobile. Maybe they may not be able to go to the vaccination center, but MOH is providing even vaccination at your home.
Okay,
so you can arrange for a team to go to your house to vaccinate. So there shouldn't be reasons that I not having the vaccination because I can't make my way there. So not to worry, and really I do encourage you know, people watching to encourage the elders at home, if they've not gone for it, to go for it. And those above 60 don't have to book any appointment. Not like you have to book for tomorrow, right? But for those over 60, they can just walk into any CC and offering vaccination and say, I want to have mine done today.
So if you have elderly at home who has not taken their vaccination, please go with them or bring them there. But remember, do not go to polyclinic for that, okay? Because due to limited
usually polyclinic is a smaller capacity. So they may not be able to take in walk-in. So but CCs are fine. And CCs would be most convenient in terms of location for many of our residents.
And although most of you, I know most people has already gotten their vaccine, a lot of people have, but there are still safety measures and stuff you have to take. Like just earlier on when we discussed about how on MRT, try not to talk, wear your mask, everything, which this is one thing that's brought a lot of concern to me. So let's take a look. Take a look first on what I experienced.
Just another day, I'm on the MRT heading home and something caught my eye. I was very unhappy with what I saw, and it is this guy wearing his mask like this. I could not tolerate such behavior and I knew that I have to do something about it. So I decided to call him. I was like, "Hey bro," and he was like, "What's up bro?" I was like, "Your mask bro," and he was like, "Paisei bro," and he wore his mask nicely.
Nice.
I mean, this is something that's been happening a lot. A lot of people like wearing their mask, like maybe just not covering their nose or mouth. But please try to keep it covered, okay? That's the whole point of your mask.
Actually, this is not just about following the law or what, you know, or you know, if you're gonna call it, pay $300. It's not. It's actually for your own safety,
yes,
right?
It is.
Yeah, it's protect yourself, because if you expose your nose or mouth, the virus in the air can you know, you can be infected with it, right? And also for the people around you. And some may think, "Oh, I'm very young, it's okay, I'm very strong, it doesn't matter, it's like a flu." But then what if an older person, if you catch it, And then a lot of the infections happen at home.
Yeah.
Household cross infections are the most common. Mm. Then if you're elderly at home, your parents or grandparents, then if they fall ill, they may not be as able as a younger person to be able to recover well. Mm. And then we read a lot of things about the long-term effects. Even a COVID patient, after recovering, there could be some lasting effects mm. on the person's health.
Yeah.
Then, because we still don't know everything about the virus. Mm. So I really hope that we can all play our part lah, yes. to keep everyone safe.
Yes, yes, yes. So not only wear a mask properly, okay, you have to wear the right kind of mask. So the surgical mask or proper mask with like 2 to 3 layers, that would be the best to fight off like the virus.
This is my mask, yeah. So I wear, yeah.
I also have.
So now we wear this kind of mask.
Yes,
now,
yes, yes.
During
yes,
the show, we. Yes, excuse because, that we are. We
yeah, no, because distancing. We are safe distance. Yeah, yes. So we are okay. See? Very 2 meters, yeah.
I mean, we keep our distance in check. After all, we have to show the face a bit, lah.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah,
if
yeah.
you cannot get enough of our face, remember to follow all of our Instagram. Okay, and we have Sir's yes. Instagram right here. Please go and follow.
Oh, thank you,
yes,
thank you.
Yes, go and follow him now. Then you can watch all his updates, how he keeps fit, how he keeps up with all the new.
Yeah,
Instagram
and check out
filters.
My selfie with Kimberly Wait. And Zijie on my story.
Okay,
yeah.
okay, I will see you later. Okay, yeah. later I will see. Sure. Okay, so Sir, before you take a leave, do you have any words for our viewers?
I think nowadays there are a lot of information around.
Mm.
Some are good information, some are fake information,
yes.
some are confusing information.
Mm.
So it's very important that you check out those that you can trust.
Mm.
For example, Noon Talk.
Wow,
yeah,
thank
very
you.
Important. Yeah.
That's so
amazing. Really, I mean, yeah, thank really, you, it's very you. Important. And, don't believe everything we see.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. can now very easy on Google, you can cross check
yes,
and then just check. Yeah, I'll check my Instagram also.
Mm,
yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So anytime they are unsure, they can come and ask
yeah,
you.
Yeah, they can
right?
PM me.
Okay.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
So don't and also don't be a spreader of such unsure news.
Mm, yeah.
You're not sure yourself. Don't yeah. say, just share because or maybe it's interesting yeah. or funny. No, yeah. it's not.
It might cause, like,
you are
panic, right?
a part of the chain, no? Mm. You know. So it's no good
mm.
because I believe now our young people are very educated. Actually, we know you
yeah.
know they're informed.
Yeah.
But just sometimes it's just I just follow a trend. I this or I really doing it, I'm doing it. But let's not do so.
Mm.
Yeah, I think really learn a lot from Zijie and Kimberly, being responsible young adults. No, that's very important, really.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
and
you
then
so
as role models, you can do a lot. In what you do, you post to remind
yes.
our audience out there what are the right things to do.
Okay, we will learn from you. Thank you very much.
Thank you
for joining us. Thank you, sir.
Please
thank
do
you.
Rest early in case you have to wake up at 6 a.m.
I have to, yeah.
Oh, no.
It's
okay,
a school day
okay.
tomorrow.
Please
oh,
rest
no.
early. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank
and
you
don't
so
miss your vaccination tomorrow.
Oh, of course, I'll be there.
Okay, wake up early and go for it.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks
a lot.
Have a good day.
Good night. Bye-bye.
Yay! Thank you! Wow, I really learned a lot today and
yeah.
very, very interesting.
And who knew that the transport has got the transport part right has so much to it itself.
Yeah.
Like there's so much to learn about our local transport history.
Yeah, it is. I'm gonna go back and read up more about it. And also just now Sir mentioned about all what we have to share on our live show, right? So here are some simple tips, right, for COVID-19 before we have our next guest up. Alright, here we go!
Okay,
guys,
you see, 回来就有礼物了,
this is especially from our second guest today, Lita!
Hello everyone, Noon Talk Media, right?
Yes, 对对对对对.
Instagram, live.
Yes.
厉害.
Alright, okay, 所以这个是什么? 我们可以开来看吗?
可以啊, 就是T-shirt啦, okay. because 最近很流行 oversized tee.
我喜欢!
是, 尤其是最近... 我吃的又多又少运动
But you prefer like more fitter, right?
以前, 现在不会了
因为我在想说 子杰每次去 gym pump 到很 fit 他应该喜欢穿比较 fitter 的衣服
没有
现在要遮一下
真的吗?
Yeah.
不用遮啦 OK 啦
Thank you
不用遮
哇, 很多
三件
如果我们的观众
If our audience want to make their purchase, right, okay, how can they make their purchase?
这么好可以宣传吗？
可以。哈利哈利的
Singapore 这个 Instagram 就可以了。还是可以看我的 live 啦。其实我 every week 我都有在做 live。
Yeah,
because you know nowadays right, very hard lah, retail ah, not easy ah.
Yeah,
we have to survive. Yeah, so we are doing live now as well.
I see, I see. Yeah.
这样子我们就把这个场交给你了。对啊，哎，你比我们更有经验，有没有？你们做的很好，哎，没有，我有看，很棒。哎，谢谢。就靠你们，哎，没有，就靠你们，需要你们一直来让我们给我们一点经验。有。然后说到现在做 retail 真的很不容易了。Doing retail is really tough for this time period.
Really.
So, how are you coping with all this during this period?
Okay, you know, especially during COVID, right? Mm. Some retail shops we are not allowed to open.
Yeah.
And recently we can open, but because of the restrictions, 就是因为没有那个 dining 嘛。是。所以在外面 even in town areas now, you can 如果你有去的话，人很少，很少。Not many shoppers around.
对。So
at first, actually, 我也对这种 live stream 不太了解。然后来看到有人在做嘛，很多像这种王雷大哥啊、马哥啊，马哥也在做啊。像之前凤姐也有啊。对。然后我就有跟他们请教啊，说 Does it really can work? No, like live streaming. Is it really like can sell? No.
Yeah.
I was quite skeptical 啦。我想说 live stream 可以卖没？有人会买没？ 我就 try 还真的会，真的有哦。 Yeah, 所以我 start from like scratch 啦，可能第一次 live 只有十个、二十个 view， 现在慢慢 view up 比较多，有一两百、两三百， depends on 你卖什么款式啦。I see. 所以 very interesting 啊，very interesting. 你可以有一个 very direct interactions. Yeah.
You see, this is a good thing about you know this period thing at home and all that. You pick up and you learn new things.
Really? Especially when you can't go out, you are a bit frustrated. So you have to start to think about, okay, what can I do? You know, don't waste your time.
Yes.
Besides playing games.
So is that what you在家里就是打 game?
My gosh.
Live stream.
我玩 PlayStation 玩到我太太已经快要认不出我了。其实我有看你的
IG， 你就是我就看到你每次玩你太太这样，对对对，要一直玩
game，一直玩。然后我们之前还有玩那个 Werewolf game， 你知道吗？啊，是。我们现在 Circuit Breaker， 哇，我们厉害，我们可以 Zoom 嘞，以前就可以 use Zoom 嘛，we can play the Werewolf game。
哦，所以你跟 几个朋友这样，对对对，很多圈内的也有，圈外有
mix around， 对啊。
So fun.
Yeah, and that's what's so awesome about digitalization.
Yeah,
I mean you can do everything. Hell, if your friends play games, all online at the comfort of your house.
Yeah, 真的真的。
那你还有做 like hosting 吗？ On
Okay, in fact, because nowadays, right, events is, we can't really do events now, lah. So a lot of clients, they should engage us to do live streaming as well. So it's another channel to exposure. 也是就是多一个赚钱的管道了。所以我觉得 live streaming 就是变成一个 trend 了啦。Yes. Yeah, and even though after COVID, right, 我是觉得还是会继续，因为 it's a trend and it's going to be one of the 我觉得可能会变成多一个大家会看的一个管道。我觉得都在
，I think 现在都有，都是了。对，每个人都在看了。每个人都在现在这样。我们有几？我看，我们有几个人？我4000多人在看。哇，你们好，你们好，你们好。哎，有人问 He's married？ 呀，你们不知道吗？Hello，
I'm married for quite a while
嘞。对呀，结婚一阵子啊。你没有看我的
IG， 我就会常常会 po 我太太的照片。哦，对对对，你每次都在 IG，
其实你每次 po 很多很好笑的。我互动的东西，
我们很喜欢互整对方。
哦，啊，对对对对，每一次会拍一些丑照，还是我在睡觉，他故意整我
pranking
啊，可爱，
a lot of pranking， 所以我们有很多把柄，哇，不可以，对我们每次讲说如果以后在一些重要场合就播出来。哦，no，哎呀，应该不错，来来，我们直接看一下，double有没有？就很美，会在那，你们的手机不可以不见，我们可以啊，其中一个人手机不见就严重了，挖鼻孔，哎，他很多我 dig nose 的照片。
每次挖鼻孔在旁边偷拍我，太过分。所以他现在有在看吗？有在看吗？他在现场啊。哦，对，现场啊。哦，在吗？来，哦，要不要爆料？要不要先？快去厕所，快去厕所。哎呀，哎，我也是看到你在家里也是很喜欢po你狗狗的。
Yes，巴利。
是吗？很可爱，很可爱。他是个 bulldog，是吗？bulldog，French
bulldog。 Yeah, so French poodle 有点nerdy，nerdy呆呆这样啦。是，它不像那个贵宾啊，poodle，poodle is very clever， 很精灵的，然后会跟你撒样撒样的。poodle 是哎
不管你的嘞，
他就
就呆呆来 living on his own world 这样的，对对对，很 cute 很呆，天然呆啊，很可爱。
就是我最近看到你 post 的一个 video， 你
对我跟他对不对
啊？你喂那个
呀， yeah， 喂食物，
对，那个很 cute，
他很开心哦。哇，刚刚一讲到食物，那个他最近有一个 fetish 哎，
啊，什么 fetish？ 狗也有 fetish。
所以 you want food therapy？ 你要 food therapy 来我家，会帮你做整套的。真的，
这么可
爱，他会帮你拎拎拎哦，把你的那种死皮啊，全部从头拎到尾，你的脚趾的那个缝哦，全部拎到你。
真
的，这样你又有新的business venture 了，人家之前很流行那个鱼，
对不对？现在你狗了，真的，他我不知道为什么还有这个 fetish 最近
这么可爱。
那现在来在家里煮饭哦，也是以前比较少，最近开始煮饭。I don't know why, is it all the aroma 还是什么，还是那个香香、uh-huh. 开始就是立我的脚哎、欸。
你在煮的时候，
我在煮的时候
可能啦，
奇怪，
以前他在 hit 你，
以前是他很聪明，他就帮我脱袜子，
他帮你脱袜 子，
我到家我就是我这样，然后巴利康他就会帮我这样摇一摇帮我脱袜子，
可爱、欸、
可是他最近就是呀开始立脚、我觉得怪怪的他去哪里学到这种？
还是因为你的脚有什么特殊的天然香啊？
最近味道比较重一点。
哎、欸、，Kimberly，
什么？我不要。
验证一下。
不要。
等一下，输了就稳。
No.
这么 fierce。
哎，其实有在家里有狗很好哎、欸。
很好。
Yeah, during this period, right, it might be very suffocating. I feel or stressful for some people.
Correct.
I think having a dog is one of the ways that let you de-stress.
Really.
And it brings happiness.
We actually have.Planning to get one more 啦，呀，所以我们讲说要领养还是要去买一些小只，我们还在看。
Adoption
is one of
adoption is one of the very good
choices.
Yeah.
养一只小狗，其实我很想知道，像你养的这只狗狗，你大概它吃一餐是多少斤？
哇，你有算吗？
我没有算，但是我跟你讲，因为狗狗哦，他们是很。They can control, you know? You have to control them.
Their food, right?
Yeah. So, 你如果不 control, 他们会一直吃到很胖。
对。
像狗，我们的狗狗 already try to control already, no? 还是很胖嘞。它最近哇，胖得像哎，找不到腰嘞。
Oh no.
对。
那给它 exercise 哎，你要。
有。
Yeah, 你要 stay healthy, 你的狗也是要。
所以我现在有空我会带它去跑 stairs 啊。
OK, 很好。
One round, 它 gone now。
它 gone 啊。
我可以给你们看一个照片，最近。
OK。
最近。最近我带他去楼下去楼下跑步，你看，哎，我只是 about 10 minutes 啊，他整个 knock out。
你说那个看吗？你说那个
knock out 哟，
很可爱。
来给他看这个，真的可以啊。
那可以看得到了。
我就把他抱在我的怀里，因为他已经 knock out 了，他没有力走了。
Oh my god， 他不是很重吗？他这样
有 11 kg， it used to be 10， now 11， yeah。
哇，这样。
OK， 要 stay
这样他也是蛮好命的哦，能吃到这样，
这样抱在这边，哇！
其实，我吃东西开销也不是很大了，要不要考虑一下？
无聊，
应该吃很多吧？
要不要领养一下？
对，千万不要，千万哇！这粉丝那么多，对
啊。所以你压力的时候，你就跟狗狗玩，
狗狗玩啦 ，play with my dog and like spend really quality time with my wife also lah， and sometimes play games and recently a lot of like。NBA Finals, Euro, 哇，每天在看哎，
对，
真的太多呢，还有 Olympics 都可以看。
So a lot of reason for you guys to stay at home.
Yeah, actually a lot of things 啊，连现在那种电视节目啊 ，like streaming channel, so many things to watch. Like all the your Marvel shows, everything 都有看，全部都有看。
对咯，对啊。And our live streams and your live stream.
对 ，live streaming.
Live stream 买东西。
啊，真的很恐怖哎。
Shopping therapy.
我觉得是有 very addictive 嘞 ，sometimes 我只是这样子 browsing through 哦，连我会。手会被控制哎，这样哎要去买，要去打那个 plus one， 真的。
那你老婆会不会阻止你？不要买这么多。
他会傻眼，他会傻眼，
oh, no.
但是他会控制啊，会控制。
OK。
那这样通常你做 live stream 的时候都是在哪里呢？
在家里哎，
在家里啦。
Stay at home 啊 ，so we get very casual， so we just decorate。Actually we didn't decorate， we just use one corner of our living room， and we do a very simple setup， and 就直接来了。哎，真的很像是像以前摆地摊在叫卖家，
你老奶奶 ，You adopt like the old 摆摊的那种。
So I'm saying we are using a very traditional way by using new technology to sell stuff， 很特别啦。
是，
对 ，Imagine 像以前你是雷龙雷龙嘛，对吧？现在你也是在雷龙雷龙吧，就是我们看不到，
是
digital age，
yeah， it's a digital pasar malam。
连我们就是用手机看哦，说哎，现在的 comment 有什么什么什么这样子。
对，
而且真的是你上半身穿的好一点，打理一下，你下半身穿个 boxers 都没有。
没有，我们是portrait，所以还是
我还是要穿。万一忘记，我先上个厕所，一站起来就走光了这样。哇，那其实这样真的不错嘞。在家，跟老婆度过时间啦，跟狗狗玩，出去走啦。其实也很忙哎，这样子。
At first 我会觉得说，it's very boring 啊，every day at home， but 搞到后面还也是，而且现在 you need to do a lot of online content 啊。
Yes.
Yeah. Basically every corner of my house 我都已经 OOTD 过了。
Oh yeah 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 yeah.
Like the corner here OOTD， 然后 balcony OOTD， so far 哇真的，而且现在有些节目啊，像我月底吧会播一个那个什么 Stay Home Cook Off。
那个就是在家里自己煮吗？自己煮比赛的。哇，所以
production they use Zoom to communicate with us， 连我们自己拍咯。 自己拍，然后我们跟对方比赛，另外一个 select 比赛煮饭
，OK，
剪成一个节目，所以现在家里也可以拍节目，很厉害，那你是煮了吗？那个拍了吗？拍了，我那天就是现学现卖啊，我是salmon roll
啊，哇，我也不懂怎么做啊，就
roll roll 到啊，还可以吃哎，quite surprise 哎，still edible
呀，go go go，哇，这样子还真的是蛮厉害的，对，因为我觉得我自己也蛮厉害的，你也是做很多东西对不对？我也是喜欢。 现学现做，可是有的时候不能吃了。
那你 compete 谁那时候？苏志成
Kevin So。
哦。
你 Because he is the host for the 三把刀二。
OK，
我是三把刀一的 host
嘛。哦，那你们两个
PK。
哇。然后我们就下赌注说，谁赢了就可以主持三把刀三。嗯。所以摸良心的说，你觉得谁比较强？他啦
，compete 是他，他是有在下厨的嘞，他是真的平时有在下厨的。可能有
beginner's luck 嘞。
哎呀呀，所以豁出去了，对不对
？OK，
还没有播，那个好像是月底才播。月底
OK，
我们会注意。对，感谢感谢，大家记得到时支持一下。是是是。那现在呢？其实，很多东西呢都有第一次尝试。嗯哼。我们也可以有一个第一次的尝试。
OK。
我们要比一下我们的默契，看一下我们的默契。
来来来来来，没问题。
OK OK。
所以现在我们是一组的。
我们的敌人就是Kimberly。没有，哇，真的，
不是你们，这样会
感觉我们在欺负他这样。是啊，不会，因为他每次欺负我，所以现在我有帮手是好的。所以，now
right，
OK，
现在我要，I will come up with a theme，
OK， a team， OK， can，
and then you can write something on the， you can write the answers on the board，
OK，
OK， so now for example， 默契啊，你们要很快的，有没有那个？这边有，来来来，继续啊，来，可以， OK，
OK，
然后你就要很快的。 写出你的答案。
Are you scared of balloon?
I am. I legit am very scared of balloon.
Allergic 啊 ，balloon 有 allergic。
I'm not allergic. I legit.
Allergic 啊 ，I know. Balloon 有 allergic 没
？No, I legit.
Okay, okay.
Okay, so, okay, so.
Okay, so.
Now I'm panicking.
Yeah, what's the rule? What's the rule? Yeah.
Okay, the rule is I have to give you two choices.
Okay.
See if you all pick the same one. But you cannot look at each other.
Okay, okay,
okay.
So, Ella, example, Kimberly's question will be, do you think Kimberly is cool? Then the answers are yes or no. Then we both will pick no, and then she have to pop.
No.
So if we both pick yes, then she also have to pop.
Yeah, as long as you both same answer.
所以我们要 telepathy.
Yeah, 要很有默契. And to all viewers. You can play the game together with us. Let us know in the comment section and see whether you have the chemistry with us as well.
Okay, okay, no problem.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay,
let's go.
Right, ready?
How?
What did I eat for dinner? Okay.
What did you eat for dinner?
It is.
这么多嘞.
Okay, 没有没有没有. 我给你两个 choice.
MCQ 啊.
我给你两个 choice 现在. Okay, 我吃. Okay. 叉龟条. 还是菜头龟. So 叉龟条 or carrot cake?
Okay.
Okay, give you all 3 seconds. What?
哎，我都写不完呢，确实。OK，来，应该是这个啦，应该是这个。哎，哎，哎，哎 ，Do you know why？
对呀，对呀。你跟叉龟雕是比较
oily 的吗？是吗
？Kimberly 没有管的，没有管的。我原来要
keep 那个 shit
嘞。还好。啊，你没有管，所以你是吃什么？我是吃叉龟雕。
我本来想写超龟雕的嘞，但是我想说他应该不会吃这么油腻的。嗯，我猜一点，猜，这是OK。第一个
try
我，证明你了解他。等一下我会看你的眼神。好，OK，OK。看对方的。我跟你打个眼色。OK，OK，OK。来来来，你来来来。
你要 pop 吧？哦哦。就是
pop 我哈。
OK，你遮到嘉宾的 camera 了啦！不是，我要遮他，所以他看不到你。OK，OK，OK，Here's
my second question.
Second question.
My second question.
What do you eat this morning, right?
No, the other one. OK, what is my favorite color? Pink or purple?
This one easy lah. This one.
No, you all have to choose the same one.
Yeah, this one confirmed 的啦. Obvious 的嘛.
我真的不用要.
No, you just have to think of what little will think.
Yeah. Okay.
Three.
This one very obvious one.
One.
这个不用想的, confirmed.
Hey, yeah.
Because she's wearing pink. Right?
Oh, 我的那个 logic,
我的那个
logic 有一点不一样的。我的是讲 OK, pink is pink, purple is Barney, Barney the dinosaur, Kimberly 好像没有什么讲过的 OK, she don't like Barney, so she don't like purple.
哇，这个很远，这逻辑很远耶，要扯到明天。
So what's your favorite color?
My color is actually purple, but it's by y'all got it.
Yes, yeah. It's okay. 我们的默契还是在
like purple.
Like purple, like wow. Light purple, like lavender purple.
Oh, lavender. Yeah. Oh, then that's
right. Yeah. Okay, it's a bit different. Okay. But okay, I don't dare to poke. Like, can you poke?
你那个麦，你那个麦可以一点吗？我是有点怕哎。等一下，你看那边那个。好了，别。等一下，我怕。
好了。不会啦，不会，我不会poke的。 Oh my god!
我很大声耶！哇！OK， 哦，好可怕
，scary 的
，OK OK，
很开心啊，很开心。我给你一个机会，你选
category，OK， 你选两个，你看以前会不会跟你一样
？Oh my，OK，
来，Kimberly，Yeah， 比较喜欢吃这两种食物的哪一种
？OK，
第一个
，OK，
cheese。
OK，
黄金的 cheese。
OK， 黄金的 cheese。
第二个， okay. 青菜。
哇，哎、欸，你这样很容易吗
？I think this one very easy 嘞 ，Right？
Yeah。
写吗？写吗？
写了写了。
因为你刚刚讲他吃那种 healthy 的啦，
没
那么容易。
Yeah。哎，你们这样不公平呢。
是要爆。
所以你还要给我选一题吗？
不要
了，你出啦，你出啦，
我自己出啊，
你自己出，你出一个男的，不然这样对他不公平。
OK， 我出多一个男的，等一下你出。OK，
可以来，
我出一个男的啊，我想一下。
Yeah, something difficult 啦。
OK， 所以比较帅，李腾还是直接？
哎呀，这个，
我跟你说，
这个还需要吗？
这个还需要写吗？
哇，有啊，你还那么在心机 ，I confirm win。
没有，我 before 说答案，我就这样讲。Uh-huh. This kind of question, right?
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to win. You don't have to let her pop the balloon. But mm-hmm. you have to make everyone happy.
Okay.
Right? Or make everyone happy, yeah.
他看到了吗？我没看到，没关系，我没有看到。
It's a win-win situation.
没有看到，你写了吗？不可以吗？没有看到。
Okay.
It's a win-win situation.
Okay. 你这样写就是我是吗？是吗？
三。
哎呀，看。哎。OK. 这样。我心目中是子杰的，但我知道他会写我。
No!
是，我们就是为了要。
我心目中是他，但他我懂他会写我，所以我为了。OK。
太容易了吧？
好，再
okay,
okay. 再一个小科的。哎呦！哎呦！哇，
很可怕。
OK OK
OK
OK，
这样吧。
什么？
下一题我们玩大一点，
玩大一点啊！
全部都爆。
全部都爆啊！哇，那一定要很难的。
而且 Kimberly 一定要自己爆。
哇！哇
！My。OK， 来。
OK，
then you must think of a tough one。
对，你要选一个男的。
I OK， you think。
我选的话一定简单啊，
那就很容易了。
对，我选了一定很简单。
哎呀，就我不知道了。
OK， 这样吧，特别嘉宾选，
我选，
但是不要留情，
不要留情。
你就给一个男的。
OK，
Kimberly 通告费都拿了，这是应该的。
Excuse me， no。
通告费是 Kimberly 一级的通告费。没有，不要讲这个，不要讲这个，太敏感。OK， 我想一下啊。因为我要想一个，就是
子杰
也要会跟我一样，但又不可以
太容易
太明显，这样人家讲我们不公平。
是，
是
等一下人家说我们欺负女孩子。
而且我要了解她，我要懂是她喜欢呢。
不用啦，不用啦。
不用吗？
不用，你要什么都可以，只要
什么都可以啊，
都可以。
哇 ，OK， 我想一下啊。哇，来这个
，OK， 了有了，想到了
，Kimberly，OK，、
okay.
是不是 single？OK，、okay, 这个我不懂，这个我不懂啊，我真的不懂啊，
哇，这蛮好笑的 ，OK，
他是不是 single？ 我真的不懂啊，嗯，我只是 guess，
那我们 y'all both say，
我觉得
，Let's see，OK，guys，、okay. okay, what do y'all think？ 嗯 ，Am I single？Yeah，
is she single？因为你知道，
我不懂啦。
女艺人哦，每次都不会公开恋情的。我们利用这个机会，有没有？观众朋友们，嗯，对不对 ？OK， 来
，OK， 你们两个解什么？
对对对，
哎呀，我等一下要解什么？很简单哎，
我还是，
你看他自己问那个问题吧，他也是有一点不懂，
我还
不懂是什么？
因为我要写的是跟子杰
一样的。
样的。OK， 来，
1、2、3。
不是，是什么？
全世界
男粉的。
什么是全世界男粉的？
他是男粉丝的女朋友，每个男粉丝的女朋友。哎，
哇，你这样男的回答很恐怖。
所以你的answer还算是情歌，
是啊，因为写给全部粉丝就不是算那种
attached 啦，不是啊，
因为我知道。Kimberly 呢，就是我当跟你是一样，因为他是全世界粉丝的，
是， <Yeah. S 1>
所以他一定要 stay single，
对，
有没有？
Excuse me，
给来，
不给，
这个没有办法了。
Kimberly， 请开始。
你可以吗？
我尽量吧。
啊，你尽力，小心啊，小心。
我怕会很痛吗？
不会痛，不会痛。
会像那个，
这个比 vaccine 还要不痛。
哦，是吗？哎呦，那 OK。所以你打了吗 ？vaccine？
哦，我打了。你打了 vaccine 没有？
我打了。
你打了，你就当做你在打，不痛不痛，快很准。
是啊。
OK， 我们帮你打气，1、2、3。
不要去想 ，Don't think about it， Don't think about it。三十秒。OK。
Not so hard。
OK。
都是你。
OK， 我跟你讲。
Why not?
Why not? We do this. You hold the needle. I push the balloon towards you.
No.
Easier.
No.
Right. You just hold it. Just hold it. That.I'll push it towards you.
你敢咩？
我敢。
你敢？
我敢，真的。
我不
敢。你 hold 住。我不敢。真的。
Yeah, don't think it works that way. Okay, 来。Okay.
我 hold 住。不要爆炸，我给你这样子 hold 住就。我没有one meter distance。
Okay, 有。
One meter. Okay.
我自己来。你碰他吗？我碰
了。不怕。哇！来，你不要碰到我手就好了，不要停下我。我怕你碰到我手哎。我觉得他碰很 scary 哎。我觉得是 anytime going to pull my finger。
我讲他没有在看的呀。
你们来哦，来这样。
呀，
我。OK， 来。
OK， 而且我没有这么怕了。
OK。
OK，
来，这个我，
这个你比较怕，
比较 scary。
你现在在
台湾 ，I'm more scary 哦。来，放 table， 呀，可以了。
Overcome your fear.
哇，你差很远呢。哦呀 ，OK，
很
厉害。
我真的很怕 balloon， 我不懂为什么。
真的很厉害。
OK，
at least you overcome it。
呀
，Thank you。
我是不怕气球 ，OK。哦，
刚才你骗我，你讲你怕。
我什么时候讲我怕？我讲
没有没有，我以为你
有
哦，没有，我听错，
就是他们以为我怕
哦，
他们以为我长这样子会怕气球，我 man 的啊。
OK，
其实代表我们的默契真的还不错，
还不错，
真的
不错。
我觉得我们硬掰的默契不错。
天哪，你们这么多 hint，
哇 ！OK， 把 Alice 我们懂啦，就是 Kimberly 真的很受男粉丝的欢迎。
哎，没有了，
有夸到你嘞，
真的，我们想的是一样的。哎，
我相信你很受女粉丝的欢迎。
哎，没有，我现在的心就在我
老婆那边。
不好意思，
不过现在当做
对，
当做不在的话，来跟在回家陪老婆之前，
我怕等下我回家那个门 lock 住啊，很多 lock 啊， I cannot go in 啊。来 go in 啊， can you go to the bedroom 啊？
是我的 sofa。
那就不止对女粉丝了，在回家陪老婆之前呢，对所有的粉丝有没有什么话要对他们说
？OK， I think it's very important to stay at home during this period. OK， 记得出门呢要这个 sanitize 你的手啊，戴口罩啊，连。Be patient lah with many things. 因为我知道有些时候我在外面会看到有人会很 frustrating， 会吵架，会什么 ？I know 了。但这两年大家都真的是很 stressed out， OK？ 所以 chill， 然后呢，就是慢慢的我们可以在外面也可以吃饭什么的，但是记得保持卫生很重要 ，OK？ 然后也多 support 啦，多 support 我们的 live stream，
对，
这个 Newport Media 的 live stream，
and 你的 live stream，
那也可以去我的
礼物，
呀，谢谢，可以到我的 Instagram、Facebook 都可以，好。感谢，希望你们会喜欢了哈。
喜欢一定会，我拍了，我 tag 你 OK。
感谢，
谢谢你，
谢谢你 ，Thank
you，Thank you。
哇，不错嘞。
Okay, I really overcome my fear today.
Yeah. 哇 ，See today you have two very fruitful things.
Yes, I learned about history of transport.
Yes,
and I overcome my balloon fear.
Yes.
Actually, I don't think it's overcome.
But at least you took the first step.
Dare to do it, lah.
Took the first step. And these are what's the most important about, like how daily life we have to progress. We have to learn every day.
Yes, that's right.
Make yourself a better person.
Yeah, correct. make myself a better person and wait for Hubert to come in.
Yeah.
Everybody has been asking, I've been seeing. Everybody is saying Li Teng is so sweet to his wife and all that. But we also have fans asking, where's Hubert?
Yeah, and since now, right, we are waiting for Hubert.
Yeah.
We are still waiting for Hubert. Uh-huh. Before I can show my gun. Oh, okay, Hubert is ready. Now, since I with me, it's not.
Hi guys, nice to be back.
Okay, how are you? Are you okay? You waited for a while today.
I was so nervous for you. I saw
really?
Her face is getting better,
Lucky it's not your business.
You're actually with me not related.
So this song is called 与我无关, and it's because Kim said 他要一首疗伤的歌曲,
对,
说这首歌叫与我无关, 希望你们喜欢,
yeah. 好,
过往早已变得平淡，甚至开始自我调侃，偶尔心头一酸，掀起一些波澜，雨天撑着的双人伞，路过最爱那家餐馆，惬意般的习惯，你清楚的圣诞，应该嘘寒问暖，还是借口不谈，那些遗憾留在心底成为旧患，开始的清醒交谈沦为平淡，望眼欲穿，等不到你的晚安，全都与我无关，反正我早已习惯一个人孤单，心酸为难也要假装自然，惨淡或灿烂全与我无关，开始的清醒交谈沦为平淡，望眼欲穿，等不到你的晚安，全都与我无关，反正我早已习惯一个人孤单，心酸为难也要假装自然，惨淡或灿烂关。耶！与我无关 by 阿荣 ，I think it's called 阿荣 ，it's called 阿荣。
Okay, I don't know why. But you have another second, you have a second guitarist today.
Today,
hello, where's your?
Our 老板 also called 阿荣。
So funny. Yeah, that one quite funny. okay, this song is not applicable to all our SM apps, okay? To all the safety management measures, you cannot say 与我无关, okay? Everything 都有你的关. Wait, how to say that in Chinese? 都有你的关, no wrong?
人人有责.
Correct. 与你无关?
与你有关。
与你有关。
无是没有。
啊、yes, yeah, I know.
与你有关。
Correct, yes.
And I think it's very important for all the vaccines. I think this is definitely for vaccinations.
嗯。
跟每个人都有关系。Because if one of us don't get vaccinated, that means it risks us, all of us,
yes.
in this social circle that you might get infected by it lah. So
correct.
I think everybody should go and infect, especially the elderly, especially,
yes.
Yeah.
So it's everybody have to play a part lah for this.
Yeah,
except for one thing, I think I have to mention this, okay? Like when you're playing, maybe when you're out in like courts and you're playing some sports, right? Because now can five people in a group ma.
Yeah.
Okay, but when you're playing sports and then some people, none of their business ah, you ni wu guan ah, then you at the sidelines, maybe you're cheerleading for your team or whatever, remember to always wear your mask, okay?
Yes.
Like only when you're doing like the vigorous activities, then you don't need to wear your mask and make sure there's always 2 to 3 meters distancing.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah. And unless it's like It's a game you cannot miss, or it's your daily exercise routine. Yeah. Otherwise, please try not to get outside as much. I mean, try not to rush out as much as soon on the 12th of July, we are opening. Yeah. You can dine out for 5 packs per table, but please try not to do that still. As much as you can stay home, stay safe.
Yeah,
definitely. I think working from home is still the default
practice now.
So I think as long as you feel unwell anytime, just go and see a doctor. Anytime. But just don't doctor hop, no clinic hop.
Go to the same doctor
and see a doctor once you're unwell.
Correct.
I think that's very, very important.
And you know, now you can see a doctor online also. There's a digital there's a digital app platform where you can see a doctor online also. So actually it's very good, and then they will send medicine to your house and all that.
But I'm always curious, if you see a doctor online, how do they
You have to. I mean, this is for probably like the smaller illnesses,
True.
Like if you really think, you just need a few like medication and all that, then they will send over to your house. But if you have like respiratory like sicknesses, that kind, just go and see a doctor. Like if you running nose, cough, all this, anything that's like ENT related, just go and see.
Just go and see a doctor
Correct.
Especially this period, like, I think last time maybe we could, but I think now just go and see a doctor. Because I think if you put everybody at risk, especially at home also. So when you're at home also, ventilate your house. I think that's very important.
Super important.
So since now most of our time, right, because every day when I scroll my Douyin, I see you lah. I just see you. I scroll my TikTok, I see you.
Thank you.
So,
thank you.
I believe you stay home a lot.
Yes, I do. And then, linking back to this, actually I recently saw an article. You know, we were always speaking about digitalization and then creating friction amongst family members, right? So I read this article online. So nowadays when we're at home, maybe your parents will come to you, don't know how to use PayNow, don't know how to use GrabPay, want to buy stuff, for example lah. Then you'll feel a bit, why they keep asking me this kind of questions? So I read this article, quite cool leh.
Okay.
So the article was saying that, just remember that when you were first born into this world, your parents taught you nothing.
Everything
from nothing. Teaching you how to walk, teaching you how to eat.
Yes.
So when you think about that, the mentality changed when they asked you to teach them all this technology stuff. So I think, when I read it, my heart like shattered.
Yeah, it's like,
why am I so impatient with parents? I think this is very important. I think this is a very good article.
I totally agree, because we grew up with this technology and this digitalization, it's easier for maybe the youngsters to pick it up. But for the older generation, maybe they might, it's different, you know,
they don't know all this.
They didn't grow up with it. So I think we can be a bit more patient to teach them and, you know, just, you know, show them what amazing things technology can do.
And also help them to scan in sometimes when you use your Trace Together
Help them
scan in. And if not, just remind them to bring their tokens out.
Easy.
That's okay.
Just tap only.
Definitely.
Really just stay home, spend more time with them. Go out if you need to help them get essential items and stuff. So stay home as much as you can.
Watch TikTok. Zijie, Kimberly and my TikTok.
Yes!
And don't talk to TikTok.
Yes.
I mean, these are the cool things that most people should be doing.
TikTok is the cool thing?
No, all the safety measures.
Safety measures is the cool thing.
All of you cool kids should be doing all this, holding the safety measures. Please don't be the one that got away, okay? And we are going to have the last song for tonight. And we'll see you on the next session, 8:30 PM.
Monday! See you on Monday!
Yes,
this Take It Away, Hubert.
Song is called The One That Got Away. Hope you guys like it.
Summer after high school, when we first met, we made out in your Mustang to Radiohead. And on my 18th birthday, we got matching tattoos. Used to steal your parents' liquor and climb to the roof. Talk about our future like we had a clue. Never planned that one day I'll be losing you. In another life, I would be your boy. We keep all our promises, be us against the world. In another life, I would make you stay, so I don't have to say you were the one that got away, the one that got away. I was true and you were my Johnny Cash. Never one without the other, we made a pact. Sometimes when I miss you, I put those records on. Someone said you had your tattoo removed. Saw you downtown singing the blues. It's time to face the music. I'm no longer your muse. In another life, I would be your boy. We keep all our promises, be us against the world. In another life, I would make you stay, so I don't have to say you were the one that got away. The one that got away. In another life, I would be your boy. We keep all our promises, be us against the world. In another life, I would make you stay, so I don't have to say you were